Hey y'all, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new, please subscribe, don't forget your button.
Well, good morning. If you would remain standing, but just go ahead and lean into that row far from you there. You'll see a hymn book that looks like this. Family, there's some scattered amongst you. And as it says in Philippians 4:6, in everything by prayer and petition, present your requests to God. We're going to sing "What a Friend We Have in Jesus." Turn, please, to hymn 435 as we sing "What a Friend We Have in Jesus." What a friend.
May we have in Jesus. This is a grace to bear.
Psalm 130 from the Old Testament reads as this way: "Out of the depths have I cried to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to the voice of my supplications. If you, Lord, should mark iniquities, O Lord, who could stand? But there is forgiveness with you, that you may be feared. I wait for the Lord, my soul does wait, and in his word do I hope. My soul waits for the Lord more than the watchman for the morning, indeed more than the watchman for the morning. O Israel, hope in the Lord, for with the Lord there is loving kindness, and with him is abundant redemption, and he will redeem Israel from all his iniquities. It was that redemption that Penny joined in. Let's all stand and we'll sing one more hymn together.
Thank you for joining me in singing our praises to our Heavenly Father. And one thing that we get to do today as we continue in our journey is to trust and obey. So hymn number 349, we'll sing the first and the fifth verses. Trust and obey.
Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable. Behold, I tell you a mystery. We will not all sleep, but we will all be changed. In the moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For this perishable must put on imperishable, and this mortal must put on immortality. But when this perishable will have put on the imperishable, and this mortal will have put on immortality, then will come about the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. That's the victory we're here today to proclaim and share one with another. The next part of the service deals with family and friends remembering. Now, please keep in mind that as we share our memories, as we tend to think about Penny and what she meant to us and the brief words that she gives, please keep in mind that we'll be leaving here soon. Don't steal my thunder as the pastor. We're going to invite to an open mic those who would like to come forward.
On this earth, were precious to me. So it was fun to be able to have that bond. I'll be honest with you, over the last several months, when I used to see her car parked in front of the laundromat, I would say a prayer on my way into the church. And anytime I saw her vehicle, it would remind me of this farm. So we will miss her here. She was just a delight to speak to. I always went out of her way to make sure she said hello to anyone who she could get in contact with.
Yeah.
I think that's enough. Anyone else? Different ways of
your friend because we saw the differences in each other, but we still embraced him. And Penny loved everybody. And every time someone came in the line and matched you, she'd give them a big hug. And it's really gonna miss her a lot. We text each other every morning and say good morning. Me and Carl do that too. I did that for Penny. She wanted to know that I was okay, and I wanted to know she was okay. But she was a really, really sweet girl. I miss her. And I know she's in a better place. She really missed her family in heaven, and I know she's with him. And I feel blessed that I got to know her while she was from her. And I hope one day that I will see.
How many miles saw for me barbecue? Penny's niece.
I did not have the privilege to know Penny in life as much as what I did in faith because of her condition. She spent a lot of time in and out of the hospital. In fact, Kathleen checked the will. She probably didn't stop for Memorial. But every time she went in, it was the issue of faith that brought her close to other people. And it was that faith she wanted shared. So in honor of her, let me share that faith she had. On the back of your bulletin, you have a passage that comes from 1 Thessalonians. We rejoice in the comfort that Scripture can give to us about what it says about our future. And in 1 Thessalonians, the Apostle Paul begins in verse number 13. He says, "But we do not want you to be uninformed, brethren, about those who are asleep," speaking specifically about those who have passed on. "We don't want you to be uninformed about those who are asleep, so that you will not grieve as do the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep in Jesus." Those two words, "in Jesus," were the definition of Penny's faith. Her faith rested not upon her own works. Penny would be the first to recognize and admit to you that she was not perfect. Her stubborn streak shone through quite often. She would stand her ground. She would defend her area. She would say her piece, and she would not be bashful about it. But her faith was something that defined her and helped her understand more about who she was. She was not prejudiced to anyone. She would hug. She hugged a statue. She hugged me. She hugged Paul. And because of that, that love was something that was given to her by Christ. She knew that she was redeemed. sin debt which she had that she could never take care of herself, she knew Jesus paid it for her. Her faith was in Jesus Christ. Her faith was not about Christ and the works he did, trusting in him as well as her own good behavior afterwards. No, her faith was in Jesus. And because of that, she trusted the promises which Scripture gives about death and life after death, how we should live our life now together, and then how we will stay eternally with the Lord. Because two times, and even additionally within the same context, the phrase appears, those who have fallen asleep. Well, within the Christian realm and also within the Jewish mind, death was not a separation that was eternal. Even to the Jewish mind, and then now to our Christian mind, death is something that is a temporal separation where we pass, we leave a mortal body, and we are in the presence of the Lord. Paul said, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. On one hand, I know Penny would be rejoicing right now, saying, why the tears? Let's dance together and let's celebrate. It's because her faith was in Jesus alone. She knew she had failures. She'd be the first to admit it. But she had a Savior that loved her beyond doubt. And her faith was in him. Her faith was not in the church. Her faith was not in any ceremony, any rite, any tradition, or any of her own good conduct. Her faith was in Jesus. She has now fallen asleep in Jesus. The reason that that gives us so much comfort is because to the Jewish mind and also to the Christian mind, this is a temporary state. Because the body that we are going to lay in the ground today, perishable as it is, will one day be resurrected, united with that soul that currently is with the Lord, and that body which is perishable will be made imperishable. It's corruptible, it will be made incorruptible. Mortal, it will be made immortal. That way we can spend eternity with Christ. Even the patriarch Job had this idea in mind of death, when I'm just falling asleep, because there will be a reunion one day. Job ends up saying this in chapter 19. As for me, I know that my Redeemer lives. And at the last, he will take his stand on the earth. I shall see God, whom I myself shall behold, and whom my eyes will see, and not another. This desire and this promise, this hope to know that we will see Christ even after death takes our bodies, we will stand in a resurrected state. Penny's faith was in Jesus. She has fallen asleep in Jesus. But she also knows perfectly well from the promises of Scripture that she has a future with Jesus. Verse 15 on the back of your bulletin says, for this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord will not precede those who have fallen asleep. They won't be left behind. When that trump sounds, when the clouds break, when the Lord descends to the clouds, and when he calls us up, they will not be left behind. No, at that moment, this perishable will put on the imperishable. And this mortal will put on immortality. And she will be reunited and be the perfect creation that God had intended to spend eternity together with the Lord. That is the hope that God gives to us. That is the promise that Scripture relays to us. Our faith when it is in Christ alone and what he did. He paid my sin debt. He knew I wasn't perfect. And he loved me. And he died in my place so that he could purchase for me eternal presence with God. You see, that's the faith in heaven. And that's what she knew the Lord would provide for her. And that's what we joy in today. So if your faith is in Jesus, if you are ready to fall asleep in Jesus, your future will be with Jesus, and we will be with Penny. So her question to you today would be, where is your soul and in whom is your soul resting? Her prayer would be, put your faith in Christ. Lord, we thank you so much for Penny and the memories we have and the life that she lived. And as family and friends together, we celebrate this time. Based upon Scripture and the promises that are contained therein, we are thankful to know she is in heaven. We are thankful for the peace you gave her through her trials, through her sickness, through her difficulties, that she knew her Redeemer lives. And now, she's with you. We rejoice. Because that same faith is the faith that we hold on to. Thank you, Lord, for the promises. Thank you for allowing your Son to die in our place. The death that we deserved, he chose to take because of love for us. And thank you, Father, that through faith in Jesus, we can now know that eternity will be our destiny. So, Father, we pray that you would continue to comfort the family. We thank you for the gift of life and what it means, the opportunity to share, the opportunity to love. And though our heart grieves, we grieve with hope. We grieve knowing that you will give comfort, that you will, Father, bring us into your eternal glory when our faith rests in your Son. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believes has eternal life. In Christ's name we pray together. Let's all stand as we begin the session now.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Once again, thank you. Carla and Gary and Anderson Funeral Home, and it's an honor that you would show me. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, a passage we used and talked about this morning. Allow me to read it again, because we joy in the resurrection that this verse promises to us. Now I say this, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable. Behold, I told you, tell you a mystery. We will not all sleep, but we will all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. And this perishable must put on the imperishable, and this mortal must put on immortality. But when this perishable will have put on the imperishable, and this mortal will have put on immortality, then will come about the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? This is our opportunity to lay to rest a dear friend. Precious as family, precious as a friend. And though the natural processes will occur, that this perishable would be laid to rest, back to dust, the Creator who created us from dust will raise this body back up into incorruption. Because we are all a unique creation of God, and His desire from the very beginning was to spend eternity with us. Because of our failure, sin debt had to be paid. Jesus Christ, God the Son, paid that debt for you and me. This is the faith that Penny rested in. And one day when that trump will sound and the Lord comes back, as we remember Penny, frail as she was, but loving as she was, she you will be raised to that perfect body that God intended from the beginning. We lay to rest here just a body, but our hearts and our memories joy in the impact she had on our lives. For some, all of our life. For others, just maybe a few years. But we joy in the life that she had and that she shared with us. And as family and friends, we thank you for your presence to be here today, to lay to rest the dear soul, Penny, known to most of us, but formerly Jean. Our prayers are with the family. Arthur, she was your twin. Not just in time, but in personality, in love. And for the family, cherish each one of the memories that you have. But even yet today, Faith, Penny wants you to understand the faith that she has. A faith that gives us hope, comfort in the moment, but hope in eternity. So let's join in prayer as we lay this body to rest. Dear Lord, we thank you for what this moment represents. Lord, every life has to come to an end. We thank you, Lord, that you gave your life for us to pay our sin debt so that we could be united with God and spend eternity together. We rejoice in the faith that Penny had. And we thank you, Father, that this faith is still available today and is offered to all, free, with no cost. Lord, I pray that each one would confess Christ, that they would place their faith in Christ alone, trust Him to be their Savior, and as Penny so often said, He is my Redeemer. He paid my price, bought me back in love. We give her to you. Thank you for the time we had with her, but we now are comforted. Rejoice knowing that we will one day see her again, as our faith is meant to be eternal. We'll give you the praise, Lord. Be with this family. Continue to comfort them. Give them safety in their travels back to their homes. Continue to give them comfort in their lives as adjustments are made. We pray that their grief and hope, and tears that will be shed, will be of fond memories for a dearly loved one. We pray your blessings, Lord, upon all. In Christ's name we pray together.
If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget you're blessed.